Hello everyone, welcome to the next video on the research paper writing. Today we will see about that how you can assess the full text articles from the Google Scholar. That is how you can find the PDF of your required document from the Google Scholar. Myself, Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, India. You can contact me, either of my email IDs are there, or simply follow this link for finding the more updated videos on the research paper writing. So first of all, what is a Google Scholar Arler? As all of you know that Google Scholar is a search engine of the Google which provide the full text of the article which are subscribed by the library, or the full text to the free of the articles are there. Free of the articles are means they are the either of the open access articles, or the researcher may put their copies on their various social medias are there. Like here, the scholars, that is a Google Scholar, also provide the article from the academic publishers, professional societies, as well as the preprints which are stored in either in the archive or any of the research gates, and many more are there. Now let's say why this video is important to all of you. So let's say I will try to search this this paper on the Google, and let me know whether this paper is you can easily download from the Google or not. So a novel divergence measurements here. So I will open this Google are there, and I can type this here. So you can see this is the title. Firstly we will verify that whether this paper is same that we are trying to search for them. You can simply click on this here, and now you can see the journal is the Journal of Intelligent and the Fuzzy System. So you can see this is the Journal of Intelligent and Fuzzy System, volume and so on. So how you get this paper free of cost from the Google are there? So once you will here, you can see there is a login to register. Either you can view or purchase. So if I click on this, they need some login ID are there. It means you are unable to find the full text freely from the Google or from the website. So but how you can find this free of cost this article free of cost from the Google? So that's a very simple, what you can do is, so my task is how you can find the free full text articles are there. So there are the various way you can search such kind of the articles freely from the Google. So there are most commonly use them are the Google, or you can say the Google Scholar. Second one is called as the PubMed, and third one is the Get Cited. What are the difference in between them? You can see that the Google Scholars are the freely accessible web search engines. Some of the articles may be accessible as the full text articles. So remember that not all the articles are there, but most of them will be easily available. Second one is a PubMed. It is a free access bibliography database which includes the contents from the MedLib. That is, here the Google Scholar is consists of all those articles, while the PubMed is accessed only from the MedLib, and many other resources are there. While the Get Cited are there, these are freely articles from the academic database which are mostly used for the peer review or the non-peer review articles are there. And make sure that only the members can add to and added to the database content. So if you open this Get Cited website, so if you are a member, you can add your document, either whether they are the peer review or the non-peer review, to them, so that the authors of the others scholars, they can read your articles as well as edit the article. So among all these three ways, the Google Scholar is one of the best and the easiest way to assess them. How you can assess them, that's I can tell you. But is that you have to firstly link your Google Scholar to the different of the university libraries. So if you are working in some of the Asia countries, so you have to assess through the Asian library or from the Europe libraries are there. So that depending upon you. So you have to firstly link your Google Scholars to the different university library. So how you can link them? So once you will link, we will see. So that is the major task, is linking the Google Scholar to the different URL. So how you can link the Google Scholar to the various URL? You have to follow some simple steps that I will explain you here. So firstly, you have to go to the Google Scholar. Like here, I can you firstly go to the Google Scholar. This is the Google Scholar are there, or else you may know that how you can simply write on say Google, and you can simply write here as a Google Scholar. So this link will appear as a scholar.google.com. So you can see either you can click directly on here or else or this. So once you will click on this, the interface will be look like say here. So this is the this photo is means that you are logging through this email ID. So once you are here, then now you can click on this link are there. Once you will click on this link, there is a options are there. Now if you create your profile, you will see on here, but there is no need of them. Then next one is that you click on the setting. Once you will click on the setting, this is the interface you have to see. Now on the left hand side, you can see that there is a language. Now you can see here this page is appear in the form of the English. So that is my language I set as a English. Now in order to find the full text article, you click on the library link. Once you click on the library link, you have seen this interface are there. Now you have to write the library accessible here. How you can add the library access? So for example, like here, if you write here as a Harvard, and then finally write the Harvard are there, that's more than enough. Click on this link, you will see the Harvard University link will check on that. Make sure that you have to access only maximum of the 5 libraries. So this is the one. Say you, I can write as a MIT, so like as MIT, and click on the search button. You will see these are the MIT are there. So if you need this are there, you can see the full text accessible here. You can click on the Melbourne Institute of Technology. You can click on the Minsky Institute of Technology and so on. So whatever you want, you click on this link button. You can check whatever you want to check it. Click on this button and can click save. So I can say click save here. Once you will click on the save, then this interface will appear. Now once you are again on this side, you can either type the title of the paper or the keyword. So look at that. If I type the title of the paper as same as that of this, now you can see the PDF, you can easily download that. So I can show you on the here, I can click on this. Now you can see the PDF are there. Now you can see the MIT library are also be there, but it is directly the PDF link. So you can click on this PDF and now you can see here. You can see the volume is 36, page number 101 to 119. You can see also from here, the page number is, volume is 36, page number 101 to 115, authors are Nancy and Dr. Garg. So you can see that authors are now here. Volume, page, DOI numbers are 18040. You can see they are same as that of this. So therefore you can see the full text of the paper is clearly downloaded easily with the help of these settings. In other than this, this is the length, this is the title of the paper. But if you want to search on the keyword basis, so you can write the some keywords are there, like say deep learning approach. So if you click on this link, you can see these all are the articles are there. You can click on this sort by date, so you can see, you can arrange them sort by date. Otherwise you can select them as per your own convenience. So once you will click on this, you can see this all are my full text articles are there. You can see the PDF full text, PDF of the full text. You can see the full text from the MIT library. You can see the PDF and many more are there. So this is the way you can simply download this here. But if sometimes if the PDF is not be easily downloaded, in case the full text is not available in the library, then you have to click on the N version are there. What is the N version are there? You can see, you can click on this, all the 6 version, all the 6 version, all the 24, all are there. So once you will click on this, I can show you in this case also. You can see I can write as a say a deep learning approach. So you can see the all the full text appear again. Again I can open it for you. You can see the first article. Now you can see the first article is completely download easily. If I go back, you can see this is the IEEE transition. You can download it from this second PDF are there. So once you will click on this, now you can see this file is downloading. Just wait for a few seconds. Now you can see this is, now you can see this is the volume number, issue number, year, and page numbers are there. So you can see the complete articles is easily downloaded. But if sometime the link is not be downloaded here, what you can do is, now you can see all are there, PDF, PDF, PDF are there, this is the PDF, all are there. But if sometimes you are unable to find this PDF, then you have to click all these 7 versions, all these 2 versions. So if I click on, say in the first case I click on the all 8 versions. So once you can click on this, you can click, you can find the full text from the MIT library. You can find the full text from the convert.io. You can find the PDF from the ACM also. You can find the PDF from the Semantic also. You can find the PDF of. So if I click these different versions for you, and we can verify that whether all these PDFs have same or not. So this is a PDF from the Semantic Scholar. This is the PDF from the Semantic Scholar. This is the PDF from the ACM. You can see that. And also, you can see the PDF from the MIT library and so on. And if you want to PDF from the EDUEL, you can see the same preprint. You can see that preprint. This is from the EUDL. This is from the Semantic Scholar, and this is from the ACM website. So this is the way you can find the PDF of the full text articles at any of there. So these are the simple ways, simple standard settings are there. So if you want to find some another videos related to this research paper writing, like what is how you can add the reference from the Google Scholar to the MS Word or the LaTeX, what is the H index, how you can identify the Scopus index, what is the JCR formula, many more are there. You can simply click on the research direction playlist under the channel name Dr. Garg. So this link is, you can find it from here. Best of luck students, best of luck researchers. Happy learning.